And we're going to put our contact name here. Now, I could start trying to think about what actually is being stored inside this column, or how I want to store my contact information. If you open up some of the pre-built contact databases, you might find that they split the name up into a surname and a family name and all this stuff. And I'm thinking about my particular usage of this and how it's going to get used later on. I don't think I need both a last name and a first name field here. I may be referring to people when I first meet them by a nickname. Later on, I may actually get to know their whole name. But I think that to suffice for now, we just need one field for a name, and we're going to put it as this short text looks about right. You get 255 characters. So something a lot of people don't understand about a database is that they may be used to using something like a spreadsheet or something. And in a spreadsheet, you can basically put any information you want in any cell on a spreadsheet. In a database, it's not the same way. You can only put specific information in certain cells or in certain columns, or in this case, they call them fields. You can only put certain kind of information in each one. And the reason they do that, the reason they restrict what kind of values you can put in there, is that it helps you structure the information so that later on, when you're using it, you will get a lot of added benefit for the type of information that you're trying to work with. So like with a spreadsheet, if you're trying to sort by dates and someone accidentally puts in there, well, any kind of information, like I don't know what time they came. I could see somebody doing that. If it was like a schedule of when people were coming in, they say sometime in the morning. Instead of saying 9 a.m. or 8 a.m., they would put, don't really know right now, get back with you on this or whatever. It's just amazing the kind of information somebody will put in there in the, you know, the day-to-day operations of using that information. When you actually format a field to a certain type of information, whether it be a numerical, like amount of money or account, the number of times somebody came by and did something, or a date, you get a lot more control over what information gets stored inside that field, and it allows you to maybe filter on it so that you can only get those that were between certain types of values, etc., etc. So right now we got our contact name. I think we're going to have an address field here. So we're going to call this address. And we're going to leave that a short text because there might be text values that are inside the address. I like to put this apartment here because sometimes people live in apartment complexes and they have an apartment number. So I know this is going to be important to what I'm doing. We'll have a city. We'll keep that as short text. Notice a lot of these fields are text fields. And that's usually the case when you're dealing with, you know, some raw information about text. Is like basically the catch-all for anything that doesn't fall within some of the more unique value type things. States, I'm going to only be doing work in the U.S. Postal code, I'm going to leave this as text, even though U.S. postal codes are just numbers. That's really because we're not doing any mathematical functions against the postal code. So there's really no need to keep that postal code as a number. We're going to give them a phone number, a primary phone. And I'll leave that as text too. And there could be good reasons for that. You can't really dial the phone from access that I know of, so it doesn't really matter. What else do I want in here? We'll get an email. I'll leave that a short text too. So it appears in this table, and we may add more columns to it later, that all of the fields are text except for the ID column. So cool. Let's just go ahead and save this, and Go back to the home. I'm going to press on save, but it's going to want me to rename this table. This save button in the upper right hand corner saves the database itself. Something about the access and the way it manages saving of records and stuff is it's odd, and I'm used to clicking on that save button and other kinds of work that I do. This is our contacts table, and press OK.